Open the floodgates, it's time for Red Flood! Hello there everyone, my name is Mountain General and I'm making Hearts of Iron 4 videos between my online classes. The ultimate Chad move, if I can say so. And today you are watching me play Hearts of Iron 4 again. It is my favorite game. And yeah, a lot of people suggested that I should play Red Flood. So I'm doing that today, and large portion of my audience is from Brazil, so today we are all going to Brazil, and then to Saxony. And don't forget to subscribe, because we are aiming for 40,000 subscribers by the end of this year, so I can play Sex with Stalin. So subscribe or you are going to Brazil. And also, if you enjoyed today's video, don't forget to leave a like, comment what country should I play next, or mod. There are a lot of mods, so you can suggest anything you want. And maybe after 100 years I can get to it. But now we are going to dive balls deep into the world of Red Flood. And the map, well, let's say it's looking pretty different from anything I have seen. And I think the Europe is looking pretty strange, like German Socialist Republic and Prussia in Ost-Prussien on the same map. You know, I would like to know who won and who lost the First World War, but I don't think that it is that important. Honestly, it looks like everyone and nobody won World War I. And yeah, in Russia you have Mr. Kolchak in charge. And well, it's looking pretty divided here. And there is also a Sweden-Norway that is only in Sweden. And also I think the Balkans are pretty strange. That Yugoslavia looks very cursed to me. But more cursed is Africa. Like, what do we have here? A Prussian Congo. I should one day play here. But not now. Also, we have a warlord era in China and India as well. And well, if you look here into United Provinces, you can see Winston Churchill here. How did he get here? Nobody knows. Not even he himself. So yeah, that's the cursed old world. But now it's time to go to the new world, to Brazil. So yeah, we here as Brazil, we start as something of a great power ourselves. We have a pretty big industry. 11 divisions that are not well equipped, but our manpower is massive. And also we are in the third international that is led by the Germans. And also there are Hungarians. F*** you, Bela Kun. And yeah, we are also a socialist country led by Filinto Müller. Also we have our own little focus tree, but I know how to make it that we will be in warlord era. So yeah, before the civil war starts, we won't be researching anything. We will just make guns. And also we will send our army deeper to Brazil, into Amazon rainforest. Also, we don't really need construction or recruiting any divisions. Now, after our first focus, we want to do three of these focuses so we can destabilize our country just a little bit to a brink of civil war. First, we will do the venue. And here you want to pick the middle option that will give 2% to vanguard socialism. Then we will continue with the delegates. Yo, nobody cares about you, Madagascar. F*** off. Now, here with the delegation, we want to pick the down option here, and then continue with the security. And now for the security, you want to pick the down option here. Our militants are going to protect us very well. And now we will do the last focus here. And the outcome of the first council, fights between the police and the revolutionary militants erupted the discussion. And now we will get oligarchic counter-revolution. Now we just want to kill all the rats. Oh yeah, baby. Now the civil fun can start. Now we are the Republic of Brazil, fighting against Brazilian Popular Republic. Unpopular opinion, you are not popular anymore. Now also my decisions that I put my whole army here make sense, because nobody is going to oppose us here. Like, see, we will be able to walk to Rio de Janeiro unopposed. And yeah, we can go on aggressive as well, because there is nobody who is going to stop us now. You see, when they come here, they are going to get killed instantly. And also some Japanese loyalists risen up. So that's pretty nice. And you see, nobody was here, because they went too deep to Brazil and never came back. Yeah, pretty easy war when you don't have to shoot anyone. I love when countries are 99% towards the capitulation. You have to take one little city in the middle of nowhere. I ask the victory in Brazil. And we will pop it now, we will annex them. I'm not stupid. And yeah, Brazil back at one piece. And nothing is going to break Brazil. Oh whoops, I let the oligarchs do whatever they want. It's not going to end up bad. Oh no, and we are experiencing a collapse. And welcome, anarchy. Anarchia, mama, sinos, my crumi. Oh yeah, that's what I love, baby. And now the warlords are going to take control in each region of Brazil. We have New Silesia, Rio Grande Republic, and a Japanese breakaway. And we will play as Nikkei Burue Ryuru something. Tenohika Banzai. Well, we are going to start from the bottom and we will work our way up. But also we have a nice little focus tree and we can do a new Japan. Well, welcome to even more chaotic Brazil. And oh boy, Mr. Miller is back. But now he's a right-wing authoritarian. And yeah, I think only few people have their own focus tree. So we will see how the reunification of Brazil is going to go down. Oh no, even Polish people made it here. It's Nova Polska, but in Brazil. Now we are a new Japan. And we will pick the loyalty to Tokyo. Now the best thing is that we don't have any military factories. And we will have to wait a good year for one. Pain. Now after we declared our loyalty to Tokyo, we have to remilitarize our country and prepare for a unification of Brazil. Samurai society done. Now we can get cores on our neighbors. Now we got cores on emergency federal government of Brazil. Now we will just work our way to the war goal here. Oh yeah baby, look at my production of guns. I have one military factory. That is amazing. Kill me. Bongo bongo, things are happening in Congo. And now it's the time to expand. You know, we are just like good old Japan back at home, fighting against weak warlords and committing some war crimes. The best thing is that the North is encircled so we can basically massacre everyone here. They were too resilient, I had to kill them all. Now we just have to get to Rio de Janeiro and the war is going to be won. You know, they have only two divisions, so we will let them in. So now we just have to break this division in the north. And we have a free way to capital city. Oh yeah, bye bye fake Brazil. They wasted themselves by attacking. And now we can finish them off. And yeah, that's the war. And now we have a massive manpower. And some industry as well. And now I also have military XP so I can make some great divisions. Now we will be slowly but surely expanding our might. Yo, and also thick Paraguay. That blue looks nice. Ah, finally, justification is ready. Nobody cares about you, Mr. Funny Hat. You are coming with me. Yeah, just let me take the capital city. And this is all over. Now I think I need a little bit of sea. Oh yeah, and I have done the last focus. Yeah, the focus tree here is really tiny. Now this war I think will be a little bit harder. I put some forts down, but we will see. But yeah, we can push, we have better divisions. Hopefully. Oh yeah, World War II started in Europe. But yeah, you see how important this event is. I can't even read the last line here. Oh yeah, another tricky encirclement of the whole country. And the best thing is that I have made them leave their capital city. So yeah, thank you Gigi. Very good war. Easy, I love tricking all the warlords. But that war showed me that I have to put some artillery into our divisions. Because we desperately need it. In our army we have a nice number of artillery. And now is also the time to create our spy agency. Yeah, something very cursed.
The snake is the closest thing to octopus here.
Oh yeah, this is very cursed. Yo, and France won the Second World War. I think they won it too quickly. Now let me test out my new upgraded army. Oh yeah, we can destroy them. We are going like it's nothing. And yeah, another fine addition to my collection. And I think now I will implement my southern strategy. Take out the southern bitches. Bye bye, Rio Grande. Yo, I think I went too far south. We are going to Brazil, and Brazil too, on my way to liberate the northern Brazil. Yeah, after I added that artillery, all the wars are easy. Yo, is this western Brazil? Because it will be. Oh yeah, the weak Brazil is dead. Miller is forever dead. And also Paraguay. I really love this Armenian knight. He's fighting against the whole world. And Turkey. Classical Armenian stuff. Anyway, we look like somebody stepped on Brazil. But now it's time to finally unify this country once and for all. And we have to go to Amazon rainforest for it. But it won't be a problem for us. As you can see, nothing stands in our way. No more brother wars. We are now complete. You know, it would be cool if we could make our own South American co-prosperity sphere. So we will make one very soon. Bruh, Turkey was annexed by Armenia. Now it's time to carve out my empire. My own new Brazilian empire. And nobody in Argentina can stop me. Now welcome to Japano-Brazilian Empire. So yeah, that's how Japanese warlord unified the whole Brazil and even more. And if you are from Brazil, don't forget to subscribe. Or you are going to Brazil. Oh wait. You are already there. Yeah, hit that subscribe button for Sex with Stalin. And also big thanks goes to my channel members. Their names are in the description and on the screen right now. And a special thanks goes to Lazuli. Thanks again, and I will see you in Brazilian rainforest.